Hello, welcome. After the fall of Lemonade, many emulation fans were left without options to emulate Nintendo 3DS games on Windows. Today, we will test two remaining projects that might be your answer, The Fork by Pablo, a former Citra developer, and Lime3DS. Both share some code, but let's find out which is better for running 3DS games. If you're only interested in the tests, jump to the timestamp in the video to skip the updates and setups. But for those who want the latest news, here's the summary. The Pablo fork has had only three updates since the fall of Citra, with no significant improvements. It now allows you to play Luigi's Mansion, Dark Moon with decent performance, but there's not much else to mention. On the other hand, Lime3DS has seen several significant updates. Version 2108 fixes for macOS devices, haptic feedback on Android to avoid accidental touches, and log improvements. Version 2109, improvements in raster cache validation, adjustments for opacity and touchscreen button sizes on Android, and removal of telemetry. In this version, Luigi's Mansion, Dark Moon was considered playable using Vulkan, but with a warning of possible crashes when using Pixelator for the first time, if it occurs, switch to OpenGL. Version 2110, fixes for Super Smash Bros., which can now be played with resolution scaling. Improved performance for Mali GPUs on Android, fixes in Android button sizes, and a general improvement in game compatibility when using Vulkan. These were the Lime3DS updates. To set up the test, we configured the native resolution multiplied by 5, which is equivalent to 2000 by 1200 pixels, ideal for those who want to play in full HD. We used the Vulkan API, and since this was a synthetic benchmark test, most games were run with unlocked FPS, resulting in accelerated scenes. However, in Fire Emblem Awakening and Resident Evil Revelations, we kept the FPS locked at 60 to assess shader compilation. Without further ado, let's get into the tests. In the first game, Fire Emblem Awakening, we displayed performance in slow motion to observe shader compilation in both projects. We noticed that the graphical interface loads faster in Lime3DS, but overall, both projects show similar performance. The significant difference is that when changing the camera position, the Pablo Citra fork needs to recompile shaders, while Lime3DS does this only in the first scene. In the second battle scene, Lime3DS no longer recompiles shaders, while the Pablo fork shows some minor flickers. The average FPS was 60 in Lime3DS and 59 in Pablo's fork. However, Lime3DS showed better performance in other metrics, with a 1% low of 27 FPS versus 7 FPS in Pablo's fork, and a minimum of 51 FPS versus 3 FPS in Pablo's fork. The only drawback of Lime3DS was the RAM usage, consuming 9.5 GB compared to 6.5 GB in Pablo's fork. I retested to check for any background processes, and although the usage decreased, Lime3DS still used 1 GB more. The second test was on Kid Icarus Uprising. This game didn't run well on previous versions of both projects, but it's now more stable. The first test, in flight, showed that Lime3DS had an average of 417 FPS compared to 305 FPS in Pablo's fork. During city exploration, the difference was smaller, but Lime3DS still had an average of 275 FPS compared to 246 FPS in Pablo's fork. One of the games where emulation is still improving is Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon. In the previous video, Lime3DS couldn't maintain more than 37 FPS, but now it's running at a stable 60 FPS. Pablo's fork, on the other hand, doesn't consistently maintain 60 FPS but is still playable. Both projects had unlocked FPS for this test, and this was the best performance I could achieve. In the Mario Kart 7 test, the results continued to favor Lime3DS, with an average of 217 FPS compared to 162 FPS in Pablo's fork. However, for the first time, Lime3DS showed a slight disadvantage in its 1% low measurement, possibly due to more shaders being compiled. Despite this, both projects still offer a completely playable experience. As per your request, we tested a Pokemon game Alpha Sapphire. Again, Lime3DS came out ahead, with an average of 489 FPS compared to 416 FPS in Pablo's Fork. This time, the RAM and VRM consumption was nearly equal in both projects. Although I didn't record the moments, shader compilation when entering battles with unseen Pokemon was still faster in Lime3DS. If you're enjoying these tests, don't forget to leave a like and a comment to boost engagement. If this is your first time on the channel, consider subscribing to stay updated on all the latest news. Resident Evil Revelations is an excellent benchmark for this system because it's one of the best-looking games on the 3DS console, but it also has issues with slow shaders. For this test, we did it in two parts, first with unlocked FPS. This time, Lime3DS showed some instability, but the difference wasn't significant, with Pablo's Fork showing an average of 178 FPS against 174 FPS in Lime3DS. In the second part, we conducted the test in slow motion to better observe shader compilation, which is crucial here. When entering a new room, lighting in Lime3DS tends to be faster, but there are moments when characters and objects disappear momentarily. However, in terms of the speed at which objects appear on the screen, both projects were almost neck and neck. Finally, we left Super Smash Bros. For last because it's the game that requires the most shader compilation. We chose a chaotic stage with 4 CPU-controlled characters, and again Lime3DS stood out, with an average of 223 FPS versus 201 FPS from Pablo's Fork. As mentioned earlier, previous versions of Lime3DS had issues when using a resolution other than the native 3DS resolution. But this has been fixed, and now the performance even exceeds that of Pablo's Fork. In conclusion, it's hard to deny the advantage of Lime3DS over Pablo's Citra Fork. Despite a slightly higher VRM and RAM usage in most games, the current standard for RAM is 16 GB, and most Steam users have about 6 GB of VRM, so this difference won't be noticeable. If you're using an integrated graphics card, 2 GB of VRM should be enough to run most games at a resolution between 3x and 4x. For systems with only 8 GB of RAM, Pablo's Fork might be a better choice. I'll leave links to both projects in the description so you can download the latest versions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.